All right, so I got to go backstage at the Grand Ole Opry, actually give Craig the hat. He went out on stage and he was singing wearing the hat we built him here at Greeley Hat Works. Just a second, let's back this up. My name's Trent Johnson. I own Greeley Hat Works, and I don't just build hats, I build dreams. I can make anybody look good in a hat. Some of the biggest names we've built hats for: Harrison Ford, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Toby Keith, the band Perry, Charlie Sheen before he went crazy.
Duh. Winning.
Vladimir Putin, both President Bushes. What? So he gets ready to walk out on stage, and he holds up the hat, and you could see my signature. And I like threw up a little in my mouth. I was so freaked out.
Thank you all.
Afterwards, he walks by me. I go, sir, it was an honor to make you that hat. He goes, you're Trent? Guys, come here. And he pulls over all the White House staff to take pictures. All the flashes, boom. Like on a movie, it's like, boom, click, boom, click. And I'm like, whoa. My staff is awesome. I ask them to jump and they ask how high and in what direction. This is Damon Smith, production manager for Greeley Hat Works. He's been with me for what, 8 years now?
At least. Seems like 20.
Sweet. Love that. Damon and I probably butt heads more than anybody. Gonna put the world away for a minute. Pretend I don't live in it. Ray Ray. She tries hard.
I'm kind of Trent's assistant, maybe. So, in a way, I do pretty much anything he needs me to do, whether he's here or he's on the road.
She's your typical beauty queen.
She needs to read my mind better.
Well, we get a lot of interesting requests, people that want to bring in their own beaver pelts, like they've caught and killed their own beavers, and they come in with these hides, and they're like, can you make me a hat out of this? Well, it doesn't exactly work quite like that. Isn't she
lovely? This is Sharon. She's been with me for about 9 years.
And everybody refers to this area as my world, and that's okay. They don't with my stuff.
Right, there I am, touching all of your stuff again.
Well, if you notice her position, she's in the center of the shop. So she's within earshot of everything that's happening.
She has super good hearing if it doesn't have to do with her. It's kind of like a 3-year-old. I think they said ice cream. Did they say ice cream? Did you say ice cream? No.
It all works out, man.
Before you ever leave this world alive, thank you for the things you did in my life.
Tamara's a great member of the team. She'll give you the shirt off her back.
I am a felon.
You know, in a job interview, you can't say, so why were you in prison? I mean, that's none of my business.
He took a chance and hired me.
She's a hard worker, and I knew that from the first time I met her.
I love Trent, and it's not just Trent, it's Sharon and Rachel and Damon. It's almost like being part of a family here.
When I'm on the road, everybody here works awesome. It's when I'm home that stuff kind of falls apart.
It's very true.
Yeah, thanks. Greeley Hat Works, this is Trent. How can I help you?
Hey, this is Craig Campbell. How you doing?
Craig Campbell is a top 40 Nashville singer.
I'm playing the Opry this weekend. I really need a new hat.
All right, yeah, no pressure. 2 days, the Grand Ole Opry.
What, can you do it?
Can you tell me the last time I told you no?
All right, man, I appreciate it.
All right, thanks, bro.
It seems like every other day we're getting some big rush job.
Rachel, I need you to pull the old orders. Sharon, Damon, Tamara, I need you guys to start thinking about what we could do. And here's the kicker. I'm going to hand deliver it to the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville, Tennessee.
When he's on that stage, it's going to be awesome.
1, 2, 3, take my hand and come with me because you look so fine that I really want to make you mine.
Bro, what's up?
Hey, man, what's happening?
Oh, just Fast and Furious,
you know?
You're
cutting it close, huh?
I'm so pumped. Everybody really pulled it together. This is a new color called Gunmetal Gray, custom made to your head, as always.
Wow.
Let's try that on.
Oh, it looks good, too.
Giving Craig that new hat was amazing, and he loved it. It was great.
It's gonna be awesome.
All right, man, have a good one. Thanks.
I know I'm gonna look good.
Oh, of course you are. All right, break a leg.
All right, brother. Appreciate it.
This is a crazy job. because not everybody could express what they want.
I still wanna move mountains.
So I have to figure out how to get into your head, to extract the picture, to turn it into felt and leather and create the hat to make you happy. It's next to impossible.
What she sees in me.
But every day, that's what we do.
It's what I wanna be when she grows up.
That's right.
Okay, hang on a second. We got a spot on that hat. Nobody saw it. I saw it. Because I'm the hat man.
Hi, Trent Johnson from Greeley Hatworks here. I'm here to tell you how to brush your hat. Now, in every hat purchase with Greeley Hatworks hats, you get the rules and regulations on how to take care of it, but you're not here. So let me tell you a little bit. Light colored hats, light colored brushes. Always brush counterclockwise on the top. Easiest way to remember that is countertop. On the bottom, you always brush it clockwise. That's the way the hair or the nap is laid down when a hat is made. Same thing for a dark hat. Dark hat, dark brush. Counterclockwise on the top, clockwise on the bottom. Remember, take it off of the table, leave it on at the bar, and treat it like your sweetheart, because your hat is as unique as your signature.
Greeley Hatworks has been making and recrafting hats for over 100 years. Since 1909, our high-quality materials and platinum customer service have set us apart from the other hat makers. We call that hatisfaction. We make more than just cowboy hats. Shop our 970 fashion line or check out any of our many collaborations, including our collaboration with Anna V. Outdoors. Hats made specially for life outdoors. Visit our store in Greeley, Colorado, or shop our selections of custom and ready-to-ship hats at GreeleyHatworks.com.
One, go.
Hi, I'm Trent. Most of you know me as a professional breakdancer, but I'm also a hat maker at Greeley Hatworks. What I'd like to show you today is how to measure your head from home. Either if you have a soft cloth tape measure and or a tape measure and a piece of string or a leather strap or something, what you're gonna do is put that around the wearer's head, where they'd like to wear it on their head. It usually goes down a little bit lower in the back, and then you're gonna ask them how tight they'd like it. Is that too loose? Is that too tight? Where it feels good. And you said that feels good?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm holding where that was here, and then what I'll do is just make a quick little mark with my pen where that is, and then we can measure that. Once you give me that measurement in inches, we can help you decide the first step, the size of your head. 22 and an eighth. So then what we'll do is ask you at home to take three pictures of the person. A straight on mug shot, a side shot, and an aerial view. That helps us see the shape of the individual's head. So you get us those measurements and those pictures, we can help you get fit from home. However, we'd also love you to come into Greeley Hatworks, where we measure you with one of our conformateurs that was invented in 1843. Now remember, if there's enough headaches in life, don't let your hat be one of them.
When I want to find myself, I like to get away. My mind takes me to the highest peaks of the peaks of the mountains. In the backwoods of nature, I feel my wild true heart. I know I'm the last man standing and the wolves are circling. But I'm not afraid. Hearing their howling tells me I'm not alone. Nature provides the elements to keep me safe. And it's right here where I stroll to hear the wisdom of my soul. Wolves, fire, the unknown, and my old faithful hat is where I find myself now.
Every great memory I've had started with a cowboy hat.
All right, guys, this gorgeous hat I am wearing is made by Colorado hat maker Trent Johnson, a.k.a. the Mad Hatter of Greeley Hat Works. He creates all the hats for the hit TV series Yellowstone, and he's the only hat maker to have presented a sitting U.S. president with a custom hat, and he even provides hats for the U.S. Army. Now, he is designing and handcrafting each hat for Scotland's most prestigious fashion show, Dress to Kilt, an event being held here in New York July 24th.
Dress to Kilt.
All of the proceeds benefit the Navy SEAL Foundation, so check out GreeleyHatWorks.com to see his work and learn more about the event and live stream at DressToKilt.com.
How's that feel?
You turned into a Manhattan?
Right?
Oh, she's laughing.
Oh.
Oh, she's like me.
I'm sorry. I would have talked slower from the beginning. No, I'm just teasing. This is beautiful. It's beautiful. Okay, so spell your first name for me.
S-A-V-A.
V-A-N-N-A-H. Last name?
Roberts.
R-O-B-E-R-T-S. Yeah, once again, email. I just think it's really cool, like, you're not laughing windows. Like, that's a good sign. Okay, so now for sister one. Yeah, I look forward to this. This will be fun. So how far is age are you two apart?
Can you guess? If we're the same age.
No, I can't.
Well, I'm older. I'm a year.
All right, sweet. That's what I thought.
I was just doing this. We've gotten twins a lot.
Well, now we'll find out if you did it at all.
Yes, this is going to tell. This is going to be the telling moment.
Did you make the hat you're wearing?
I did. Thank you.
Oh, are they kind of similar?
Not this size,
maybe.
No.
But your head.
No, it looks like, honestly, it looks like you both are about the same circumference, but completely different shapes.
Get up. Shoddy wants you. Shoddy needs you.
My head is shaped like a pear.
Spell your first name for me.
S-A-M.
S-A.
M-A-R-N.
So you just dispel the twin blocks.
Good evening. My name's Trent Johnson, and from a very young age, I had a passion for hats. I just didn't really know how deep this passion was or where this passion would take me until a friend or a customer or a friend-a-mer called me one evening and said, you know, he's like, Trent, you know, you've made me hats. This guy lived on the West Coast. He was a pseudo cowboy now, but he was a surfer. And he's like, you know, I mean, you made my hats. I love my hats. And I know you've built hats for the president and the Emir of Kuwait and all these other people in movies. But like, how did you get into hats? And why did you choose hats? And I thought to myself, well, it took me a minute to kind of comprehend his question, but I didn't choose to be a hat maker. I really think it kind of chose me. From a very young age, both of my grandparents, my grandpa Johnson in Pueblo, he always wore hats, and he had this silver Resistol. I played the Lone Ranger in that. And then he had this brown Stetson fedora. And when he gave me this hat, it still had the price tag in there, $10. And it was from the 40s, so that was like, what is that now, like $1 billion or something? And so I got to wear this hat, and this is like the early 80s, and I had it, and I got this, I saved up my money, and I bought this genuine synthetic Taiwanese leather jacket, and I had this bullwhip that I got at, I think I got it at Mesa Verde, and I was Indiana Jones, and it was the coolest. And after that, like, the passion for hats kind of kept growing, and 1982, we went on a family vacation to Epcot Center. I think it was the year it opened. And anybody out there that might know me a little bit knows I'm really not very normal. But I saved all my vacation money. And at all the different countries, I bought hats. I bought a hat. I bought a fez in Morocco. I bought a beret in France. I mean, like, that would be normal for my kids. They've kind of grown up in my business. But that wasn't normal for me. But it was normal for me. But not for kids my age. Like, Hot Wheels, cool, comic books, baseball cards. But I collected hats. And that just was kind of off. So if we fast forward a little bit more, kind of how I got the entrepreneurial bug and got to incorporate my passion is from these two things right here. Yeah, right? My buddy Ray had we were skateboarders. And we lived in Pueblo, and we went to Colorado Springs and went skateboarding downtown. And we got to go to Wave Rave, because every good landlocked state needs a good surf shop. Totally makes sense. But we went in there, and we all skated board in there, and we looked, and there was this Maui and Sun t-shirt with the Shark Man. It had the Shark Man on the back, but this shirt was like $15, and I didn't have $15. So my friend Ray, his mom says, well, if you come mow my lawn, I'll buy you the t-shirt. Seemed like a fair trade. I just didn't realize how big their yard was. But I got my t-shirt. And I'm kind of OCD in like the whole straight line thing when you're mowing the lawn, and then like 3 inches over so you get the nice overlap on the tire tracks. But other people took notice of this, and pretty soon some other neighbors and some other folks asked me to mow their lawn. So I went to my dad. I was like, man, I'm starting a business. It's Trent's Lawn Service. And he's like, that sounds like a great idea. So I went to the shed to go get the lawnmower, and he's like, just a second. That's my lawnmower. I went, well, but I use it to mow the lawn. He's like, no, that's one of your chores. That's my lawnmower. I'm like, but I have all these jobs lined up. He goes, I'll tell you what, I'll rent it to you. I'm like, what a jerk. I might have used a few other words, but they told me PG. So what a jerk. So anyhow, my first goal now is to make enough money to get out from underneath the man. So I mow lawns, straight lines. And I save up enough money, I buy my own mower, my own trimmer, my own gas can, trash cans, everything. And so now, like, I'm out from underneath the man. I can mow lawns. I can make money. I'm a free man. So I mow lawns. But then my dad was a school teacher, and some of the teachers took notice of my crafty, straight-lined OCD yard work and asked me. One of them, Mrs. Parton, she lived over on Pitkin, and it was a long ways away. And but now I'm like, oh, I could do this. So Mr. Cacciatore, who had the classroom across from my dad, he had a trailer for sale. So I saved up my money and I bought this trailer. And like, I'm like, man, I'm expanding all throughout the south side of Pueblo. So there was one thing I didn't really think through is I'm not old enough to drive. So I go to my dad, I tell him about my business opportunity. He's like, that sounds like a great idea. I'll just charge you mileage. I'm like, oh my gosh, you're killing me, Gary. And he didn't like it when I called him Gary. I'm supposed to call him Dad. But I'm like, what a jerk, with some other words, PG, Trent, PG. What a jerk. So anyhow, he drives me in the Subaru with my trailer, with my stuff that I paid for. Finally, I got old enough, and I bought a 1982 Datsun truck. That's the predecessor of the Nissan, to you younger folks. Okay, so now I am free. I'm out from underneath the man, and now I have some employees. I'm in high school, and I always ask my dad, like, who are the cool eighth graders? Who are the hard workers? Dad, who do you like? And so I would interview these eighth graders, and I'd always get my lawns in little pockets so I could stop and drop them off to do my work, and I could go hang out with my friends that didn't have to have jobs because they were spoiled. They weren't all spoiled, but some of them were. But at the same time, I was a ski racer. Yeah, like slalom, giant slalom, downhill. And one of my sponsors was Oakley. And they would send me these box of sunglasses the year before they came out. Like the cool ones. We're talking like 85 with a little Oakley sticker across the forehead. Nobody in Pueblo had those except for me. So now it's time. It's payday. So here come the eighth graders. It's like, well, do you guys want cash or do you want new Oakley sunglasses? Oh, yeah. The barter system. So, of course, they're eighth grade boys. And they have sunglasses that nobody else in town has. So there we go. So I was making bank. But now, so my senior year, and one of my employees, Jeff Santos, I offer, and he buys my business. I sold a business that I started in middle school for book money. I sold it for book money, okay? So I sold this business for book money, and I had put out applications to all these schools, and I got denied from all of them except for UNC. And at the time, it kind of felt like a curse. My dad went to school here, my mom went to school here, and I did not want to follow in their footsteps. They're the ones charging me rent. Now, my song has changed a little, because now I am straight out of Greeley. But at the time, I did not want to be here. But boy, am I so glad I got stuck in Greeley. So I was going to change the world. I was going to be an entrepreneur. I was going to go to business school. I didn't know that you kind of had to test into it and have good grades. So I didn't get into business school. Because, I like to jab at my dad back in the day, is those who can do, and those who can't do, teach, Dad. That was a joke at my dad. I actually went to school to be a teacher. I got along great with the kids, not so well with the parents. And during this time, I actually got a job on a ranch, just west of town, and it was Ed and Sue Orr's ranch. And I think one of the reasons they hired me, besides my strong work ethic and OCD-ness, is I didn't really know anything. And so I didn't try to build fence the way my granddaddy's granddaddy's granddaddy taught me. I was a sponge. But at the ranch, in the barn, was this little hat shop where we made cool hats like this. And the smell, the equipment, everything, it was just, I was in awe. I mean, I might have cut class to wash hats. And so I was working on the ranch and getting to work in the hat shop. It was like a dream come true. So during my second senior year, because I was on the five-year plan, but I knew how to shape hats, I was trying to figure out how I could buy a hat shop. So I started doing research. Now this is, kids out there, this is like green screen computer, like barely internet, okay? So I was like, I don't even remember how I did it, but it was really painstaking. And I couldn't find any equipment. So I finally went to Ed and Sue Orr and was like, hey, do you guys think you would sell this to me? And they're like, well, why don't you put together a business plan? Well, I wasn't smart enough to get into business school. So what do you do? So I actually went to the Small Business Development Center at night, and I took classes and learned how to write a business plan. And Ed's secretary, Ann, typed it on a typewriter. That's before the computer. On a typewriter. She typed it for me. And it was, I was ready. I was gonna buy this hat shop. I mean, how could I not succeed? We made 60 hats a year. And during all of this little commotion of learning to buy the hat shop, I didn't know how crazy my life was gonna get, because at that very time, I met the love of my life. But I didn't know she was the love of my life. She told me she was the love of my life and that we were gonna be married. But anyhow, so, I mean, it was my second senior year. I'm falling in love, and I'm going to buy a hat shop. So I started going to banks with my business plan, and, you know, like, I didn't really have a suit, but, like, I tucked in my shirt and stuff. And no banks, like, banks would come to the store, and I'd show them all this cool equipment. This was made in 1843. This was made in 1850. This is where we pressed the hats, and they're like, this all looks like a bunch of junk. So all the banks told me no. Every bank in town, and I'm not joking, every bank in town told me no. So I went to my friend Joel. I went to his dad. He was a really smart businessman. I sent him my business plan. He's like, man, this looks like a lot of work for very little return. I'm like, but I could turn it around. I could build 120 hats next year. And he's like, well, you know, I'm going to pass, but here are some things I'd work on. So I worked on the things he told me about, and I sent it to my Uncle Dick in Birmingham, Alabama. And he looks at it, and he's like, well, in his accent, I can't do it. You guys would hit me. But he says, you know what? I'm going to loan you the money. And I'm like, okay, that's great. But, like, remember, I went to night classes to learn business, so I know the questions to ask. I was like, so what's the interest rate? And he's like, I'll tell you what, Trent. Every year you owe me money, you have to build me one custom hat. I'm like, that's a pretty sweet deal. So I take that. Now I'm still short half the money, and I don't know what to do. All the banks have told me no. My uncle gave me half on a loan, so I don't want to do this because I really dislike those jerks, my parents. So I go to my parents, lay out the business plan. I'm like, well, you guys, you know, take a look, take your time, tell me what you think, let me know if you have any questions. You know, Uncle Dick is going to loan me half the money. And they look at it, and they push it and push it across the table, and they tell me no. They're not going to loan me the money. I'm just like, I'm beside myself. I'm like, but why not? And they're like, well, remember when you said we were jerks and we rented you the lawnmower and we charged you rent? I'm like, yeah. They're like, well, we invested all that money, but we wanted you to earn it. Sorry. Is that not odd? My parents are the coolest jerks in the world, right? So I got to buy Greeley Hat Works. And, you know, it's taken me a lot of places. I travel the world. I've met presidents. I do all kinds of cool stuff. But my friend that asked me about how I got started in my Maui and Son t-shirt, I turned the tables and I asked him, I was like, well, Rich, you know, you're a cool guy, pseudo cowboy surfer dude. How did you get your start? And he's like, well, Trent, you know, it was the late 70s, early 80s. We were smoking a lot of pot, living on the beach. We got the munchies. I'm like, okay. I'm not sure where this is going. And he goes, so we started making cookies. And we sold those cookies on the beach. And we came up with a little logo that was like a cookie, but had all the little elements of the earth on it. And that's how we started Maui and Son Surf Company. What? The guy that inspired me thinks I'm cool? I mean, it doesn't get better than that, right? So because of OCDs, lawnmowers, and the shark man, and my passion for hats has put me here in this awesome community. So I'm going to thank you all for coming. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.